the third important session of our principles of personal investment management is principles of investment. Liquidity, safety or securities, and profitability. Liquidity, safety and profitability, these three are important principles of investment which we are going to discuss. So in our earlier sessions, we have discussed about need for investment, areas of investment policy. Principles of investment are principles of liquidity. Liquidity is ability to get back the amount of investment. Principles of loan investment, principles of savings, principles of services, principles of secrecy, and principle of efficiency are the principles of investment. Liquidity principle talks about ability of the firm to generate income soon. Principle of solvency is ability to repay the amount. Principle of loan investment, principle of savings, principle of service, and principle of secrecy, and principle of efficiencies are the principles which we'll discuss in the next slides. What is liquidity? Liquidity is the ability of an asset to get converted into cash immediately. Normally, immediately means within a year or operating cycle. What is a year? Within a year means 1 year or shorter than that. The assets which are liquid assets are within 1 year, which can be converted. But then here, liquidity means immediate conversions of asset into money. So liquidity is important for the individuals and firms to meet short-term commitments. Firms will have to meet the working capitals and daily cash needs. So that is why liquidity is very important. And emergency situations also, liquidity is required. In emergency situation, if you are having a marketable securities like shares or mutual funds, which you can just convert into cash within no time, in the sense 1 or 2 days, working days. But whereas if you are having land, it will take 3 to 4 months to get converted into cash. So that is how the liquidity difference. The firms and individuals need to strike a proper balance between liquidity and profitability. Higher the liquidity, lesser will the profitability sometimes. And risk also, that's a fact. That's why liquidity and profitability has to be properly controlled and properly marked, properly balanced. Holding excess cash or cash equivalent may dent profitability. If you are having more cash, cash in itself is not a productive asset at all. So you have to be careful. Types of liquid asset: cash. It is the most liquid asset. It includes cash in hand and cash at bank, cash equivalents. The short-term securities with short-term maturity up to 3 months is called cash equivalents. Commercial paper and treasury bills are the cash equivalents. Accrued income, income earned but not yet received or expected to receive soon. It is not earned. It is earned but not received. That's called accrued income, like interest receivable, etc. Stocks. Stock market security is highly liquid due to the existence of large number of buyers and sellers. The stock market securities are liquid because you can able to sell it anytime because the availability of the key player in the market, that is the day traders. Though day trading is not good per se, but from the point of view of marketing or getting the ready market, this data traders play an important role in stock market. So stock security is highly liquid. You can sell anytime you want. Government bonds, these bonds are well established secondary market and enabling high liquidity because government bonds can be sold in money market, so it has got good liquidity. Promissory notes, written promise to pay specified money on particular date. It's a negotiable instrument, endorsable and discountable, so highly liquid. Promissory note is a written guarantee, which is negotiable as well. So as per the Negotiable Instrument Act, a bill of exchange is a promissory note. Bill of exchange or a promissory note is an instrument in writing which contains an order to pay a certain sum of money to the bearer or the person who has got that particular instrument on the time of maturity. So this is what promissory note is all about. Then account receivable, invoices, bills generated but not yet received, shortly receivable, so it is liquid. Securities used by listed public companies are also highly liquid assets. It has got active secondary market. Then equity, debt, hybrid, long-term or short-term securities which are tradable is also liquid assets. Different types of measuring liquidity. Market liquidity, it indicates the condition of market when assets may be purchased or sold of quickly, because the working of trading cycle of a, for example, stock market security, earlier it has to be the settlement takes is to be taking 15 days or so. Now it is T plus one settlement. It can do it, the settlement quickly after trading. Similarly, in mutual funds, you can set off, you can get back your fund money within 3 days. So that is how, that is a liquidity. Real estate market is liquid, less liquid, because you cannot sell your real estate as an asset so quickly. It requires a lot of long legal procedure to be followed and performed, registration and other things. Equity market is highly liquid. Accounting liquidity is the ease at which company or individual is capable of meeting financial obligations. It is measured using liquid ratios like current ratio, quick ratio, and cash ratio. Liquidity management. It describes the company's ability to meet financial obligation through cash flow, funding activities, and capital management. Ability to meet financial obligation through cash flow, funding activities, and capital management. So, if a company is able to properly manage the cash budget and flow of funds, properly sequence it, it can able to manage the liquidity better, because excess cash is not good, too less cash is also not good. Cash should be available whenever it is required. Cash should be invested in securities in such a way that it can be availed anytime. It can be cashed and cashed anytime, any point in time, without much delay. Liquidity is measured in terms of tradability of securities from individual perspective. So whether it is tradable or not, that is the question of liquidity. For example, if you deposit in fixed deposit in banks, it takes 1 year or 2 years to withdraw. So liquidity is not there. Even if you want to withdraw, you have to make fine. You have to, foot the fine. So that is the thing. Next is, from the point of banks, it's the ability of banks to meet collateral obligation without incurring loss. Stakeholders look the financial statement to gauge the liquidity position. To understand the liquidity position, they look into the current ratio and quick ratio, cash ratio. When companies use more debt instrument over leverage, or over leverage, their liquidity risk is much higher. There are two types of companies. Companies use more debt in their capital, which is called levered firm. Leverage is good, but risk is also high. Then the banks are obliged to maintain highest standard of liquidity to demand payments. Second principle is safety and security. Safety principle looks at two important aspects. So safety principle ensure regular and assured return on investment. So the main objective of safety is that the investors must get his amount invested, that is a capital part. Also, he must get the assured rate of return on investment. That is called return on investment, assured or expected return. Assured redemption of original investment. Investment in return securities leads to high risk. High return securities leads to high risk. Higher the risk, higher will be the return. That is how the principle. Risk. Risk is the deviation from expected outcome of an investment proposal. So you expect certain return, but sometimes you may not able to get the same return what you expected. So risk is a random variable event. Safety tips for investors. An individual investor has to take some precautions to ensure safety of his regular income and recoupment of capital outlay. Always he must deal with SEBI, that is Securities and Exchange Board of India, authorized intermediaries. That is, it could be depository participant, it could be banks, whoever it may be, but it has to be authorized. So regarding these things, SEBI and other things, we'll discuss in the later parts. Get well informed about the financial instrument, and you need to know about what is its conditions, what is covenants, what is interest rate, when has we have to pay, what are the hidden charges, everything you need to know. Do not pay attention to rumors. People are always, believing in rumors. You have to stop believing in rumors. You have to believe in the offer documents. And before signing the offer documents, you have to be careful. You have to read or make yourself understand that, because ignorance here, jury is non-exhaust. Ignorance of law is not an excuse. Ask for written documents. Always written documents is useful. Beware of hidden charges. Sometimes there is a hidden charges which you have to be very careful, and you have to ensure that there is no hidden charges. Be careful from fisher and scammers in online dealings. Whenever you are doing with the online dealing, there is a possibility of the hackers or fishers who might hijack your security itself or your money. So that's a possibility. Check the online transaction regularly. Safe investment in India. Bank deposit is the most safe investment in India because the banks are supposed to pay amount anytime for you, and there is a section because it's government controlled bank, most of the banks. Public provident fund is also safe security investment. National pension scheme, that is a new pension scheme, which is also a very good scheme, which is incorporated by government of India for its employees. And national pension scheme, you get 14% contribution by central government and 10% contribution by you can contribute 10% of your salary. Gold is safe, but not always that safe, but safe. Some extent it is safe because you get immediate liquidity for that. Equity linked savings schemes is one of the schemes which is safe bet of mutual fund investment, which we will discuss in the later stages of mutual funds. Recurring deposit is good. It's a kind of systematic investment wherein you can just keep on investing on a regular, depositing the amount on a regular interval as and when you get the salary or as and when you are getting some arrear payments. Safe investment in India, again, direct equity is a safe investment. Equity in mutual funds is a safe investment. Debt mutual funds, because mutual funds I'm not going to discuss now because it will be later stages we'll discuss. Senior citizen savings schemes of Government of India, it's Pradhan Mantri Vadhana Yojana. Real estate is also safe, but then you should have excess money. You should know if you are having a liquidity crunch, real estate is not good, but for the long run, it is good investment. So these are all the principles of investment and some of the avenues of investment which you can bet on, you can put your money. And thank you for watching this and listening to me. Thank you.